Welcome to EBC Learning's course on procedure and practical aspects of consumer law. You can access our course on essentials of consumer protection law for conceptual clarity. In this course, I'll be dealing with the procedure and practical aspects of consumer grievance redressal. But before that, let me introduce myself. I'm Dr. Pratima Narayan. I'm an advocate and founder partner of Technology Consulting LLP, which is a law firm based out of Bengaluru. And we are a team with vast collective expertise on alternative dispute resolution, information technology, intellectual property rights, and consumer protection. My latest book on electronic commerce, Legal Compliance Handbook, is published by EBC. So that's a bit about myself. And now, coming to the course. This course is designed to help you understand 1. How to escalate a consumer grievance. 2. Procedural aspects of filing a consumer complaint. And 3. The remedies available to a consumer in case of a grievance. Through this course, I will also be sharing with you supplements such as sample draft of consumer complaint, legal notice, affidavit, etc. This would be like a do-it-yourself guide to help you draft complaints in a professional manner, which is vital for taking a legal action before consumer forums. Consumption of goods and services of various kinds are an integral part of our daily lives. But little do we make an effort to understand our rights and responsibilities until we end up in a bad transaction. It is important for us to have a basic comprehension of the legal rights and responsibilities so as to make an informed decision about the goods and services that we purchase. The very purpose of developing this course has been to enhance consumer education and awareness and thereby achieve the objectives of consumer protection to its fullest. This course will help you understand who can file a consumer complaint and the manner of escalating a consumer complaint. Consumer confidence primarily involves two convictions: that the consumer gets what he expects, and if things go wrong, the consumer can seek a remedy. This course will also help you understand the basic procedures involved in filing a complaint. You'll also learn where to file a complaint and what remedies are available under the consumer protection law. I'll be bringing some real-time instances and cases that will give you an idea of not only some of the concepts of consumer protection, but practically apply the subject to your own professional and personal circumstances and legal jurisdiction. In all, this course is a practical guide for every consumer, consumer activist, law students, and lawyers supporting the cause of consumer movement and protection. In this course, we'll be covering consumer dispute redressal agencies, hierarchy of consumer dispute redressal agencies, territorial jurisdiction, pecuniary jurisdiction, appellate and revisional jurisdiction, and transfer of cases. We'll also be covering various approaches to consumer dispute resolution prior to filing a complaint. You'll learn how to escalate complaint with business entities and complaint escalation with regulatory authorities such as telecom, insurance, and banking authorities. I'll give you a brief introduction to the Central Consumer Protection Authority. Thereafter, I'll guide you on the practical aspects of filing consumer complaints. You'll have some hands-on experience in drafting legal notice, consumer complaint, filing a class action suit and affidavit, and some important clauses that you should keep in mind while drafting such documents. You'll also learn about gathering evidence supporting consumer complaint and fee for filing consumer complaints. Finally, we'll deal with the procedural aspects of consumer complaint redressal, such as manner of filing complaint, procedure after filing complaint, limitation period, inordinate delay in filing suits, joinder of parties, remedial measures, and enforcement of orders. So, what are we waiting for? Let's start learning.